So yeah, I don't give a fuck at all.
And that's why we have Han here. Welcome back to the Soldiers Podcast. Well,
just cut that.
Yeah, all that shit's cut. No, but I'm going. Welcome to the Soldiers Podcast, man. We have Han here. Well, Han, what's up, man?
I'm good. Good. So finally, no BSBL Sunday.
No BSBL.
Finally, come over here.
First break in 12 years.
First break in how long? Before we get to BSBL, because I want you to explain all that and what BSBL is and all this. I want you guys to react to this. You know Dr. J?
Heard of Dr. J?
Dr. J has a... He released a...
Are you going to say he's the GOAT? Because I agree.
KB, you know you don't agree with that shit. You know you don't agree with that.
Why not? Change the game forever.
Yeah. Got the doctor in front of him, surely.
He is one of those guys. But he has a list, just like we all do.
Oh, did you release a list?
He released a list of his top 10.
Oh, okay.
Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Yep.
A.K.A. Lewis Alcindor.
Yep.
Michael Jordan, your guy.
Yep.
Your guy.
Can't complain.
But he's in the next five. That's not the first five.
Yeah, absolutely.
He's in the next five. He's not that good. Irving Magic Johnson.
Yep.
That's three.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then he said probably Karl Malone.
Yeah.
And he says he argues between it's between Tim Duncan and Karl Malone. And then lastly, Tiny Archibald.
Yep.
You know who that is.
Yeah.
I actually
know Tiny Archibald.
Anyway, here you go. So who's his top five?
So that's the bottom five.
Yeah.
The top five are...
Yep.
Bill Russell.
Yep.
11 championships. Will Chamberlain.
Yep.
Missed 100 points. Yep. Averaged like 50.
Yeah.
Oscar Robertson. You know him very well. I used to have to fucking study this guy, kind of. Couldn't find any fucking footage. He's just trying to get me to study. He's trying to get me to study this guy. There's no footage. There's no footage. It's like 45 seconds of him. But anyway, man.
Of him just killing people.
Of him killing people, yeah. And then the last two are Jerry West, Mr. Logo, and Elgin Baylor.
Yep.
That's his top 10.
Hell yes.
I knew you would love it. I knew you would love it.
Love it. Firstly, two things. One... No one out there even knows what this guy's talking about. They're like,
who are those names?
I don't even know who they are. I didn't even know who they are.
They're GMs.
like, GMs. I don't even, you know, who are you even talking about? They're like, how? And the thing is they don't sell tickets. They're not going to help the NBA, you know, earn $2 billion. They're not going to help Jaylen Brown earn $306 million.
306.
Was it 306?
It was three something
million.
Oh my goodness.
You know what I mean? Like that's what Jaylen Brown, and we talk about worth and we say Jaylen Brown's got that. What would Kareem have been worth, you know, in his prime? Like
304, you know, over 5 years.
Yeah. But what I'm saying is, like, you know, people say that's why they're worth more. And it's like, well, what would Kareem have been worth? What would a guy who averaged 50 be worth? You know what I mean? Like, who got 100 points. Imagine selling that guy in today's NBA.
But back then they sold him very well and it was a sensation, right?
But there was no market, right? But imagine what he, like, with now the media and the instant thing. And
with today's...
Like, it would just be insane because they can sell anything now.
Well, it would be the French kid, Wembanyama.
Except...
Wimbledon.
Yeah, except there's someone who can, you know, tricep extend 90 kilos.
What do you mean?
So Arnold Schwarzenegger talks about Wilt coming into the gym and Arnold Schwarzenegger and all those dudes saying, nah, we've got to stop working out. Everyone stopped working out when he was there.
Yeah, because
he was stronger than all of them.
Yeah, he was killing everyone.
So he would go get the, you know, tricep extensions,
which
you struggle at 20 kilos.
Yeah.
And he was doing 86 kilos. So almost like tricep extensions, not bench, just doing this.
Yeah, this dude, he's
trying. And all those guys are like, nah. So you're right. It is that guy, but... Somebody who's actually got ridiculously 48-inch vertical.
Oh, but it would be different now. I think the hype would be different because, obviously, if he was in today's time, he'd have a different skill set because he'd have seen more. But no, the reason Wimbledon, I don't know his name, man. reason Wimbledon's stock is so high is because he can do all those other things.
Yeah,
and he's foreign, and we haven't seen that much of him.
And I love what he can do, but my point is that is the most ridiculous athlete ever seen, ever. Like, he had a 48-inch vert. You know know what I mean? Yeah. Like he was stronger than bodybuilders who did that for a living. Like,
yeah,
it there's nothing comparable. You know, if you add skill, and that's untrained. That's like, you know, that's not like with today's training. So you put in skills, you put in training, you put in that. We're talking about a human who's just unfathomable. You know what I mean?
And was wilding on the weekends. And probably weekdays.
And weekdays.
And definitely weekdays.
Weekdays. Like what is it, 20,000 is his number? 30,000?
He made, 20,000 shots, about 30,000 shots, something like that.
No.
30,000 points.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, 30,000.
30,000 points. Exactly. Same thing.
Same thing. 30,000 hits. So
30,000 hits.
You know, like it's just...
But don't you agree? So, because if you believe in the evolution of the game, do you agree with the evolution of the game? That it's supposed to get better? Or does
different.
Get better?
Definitely
or
with different. The technology and the training.
But different is better.
With all these like technologies and they look into like certain movements and everything, I do think players are getting better and better. But they're, I don't know, they're more like robots. Everyone's going through the same system, maybe.
Yeah.
But finding someone that's like rare, like will, like rare specimen.
It's physically different.
It's just physically different. Imagine putting him into this system, getting trained up, probably just dominate the league.
But here's the thing. You watch the NBA pre-draft every year. There's guys who are doing, I don't know if it's that, but there's guys, and they're probably buried deep in the G League. There's guys who are doing 45-inch vert at 7 foot or whatever. You see it all the time. But then you never see those guys again. Oh, they're deep in the bench.
Why?
Yeah, maybe because they're not good.
maybe they can't play basketball.
Maybe they can't play basketball. So as much as, physically, yes, it's evolved. Skill-wise, it has evolved. It's just the majority isn't going to be there.
I don't know if physically it has evolved. I think the training has evolved. So they're maximizing the like humans themselves. Like
recovery.
but also like, you know, the technology and the weights and all that stuff and the plyometrics. But in terms of human development, humans haven't become any more evolved. They're no faster. There's nothing. They're actually not any, as it's humans, as bodies, they're not any further forward than they have been for the last 100 years.
So how do you explain when people break records?
Technology. It's all technology. So when they talk about the 100-meter running, so someone actually did a study on this. They talk about 100-meter running. They're like, what's the biggest thing? They're like, so they got Jesse Owens, right? Jesse Owens won all those gold medals.
Mm-hmm. The American, right?
Yeah. Yep. But what did he run on? He ran on gravel. So they like did physics, and they're like, well, if you run on gravel, there's this much force goes in the ground, this much force is returned. What do we run on now? We run on rubberized tracks, right? And they're like, so this guy traced it all through, and he's like, where's the biggest improvements in human performance is when they change technology. So they're running on better surfaces better surfaces. Yeah. So there's actually better energy transfer back to their body. So they're like, Usain Bolt is running, like Jesse Owens is like really comparable to Usain Bolt. Like they're saying this guy, like, you know, one of the greatest of all time is almost the same as Usain Bolt, but what's better? Well, the return and the energy on the track. And this is like, this guy's like a physicist. He's like, swimming, where are the records won? When Australians brought in those bodysuits. You know what I mean? They're a little bit more buoyant. They're a little bit, you know, and so, or training technology. But the human body itself hasn't evolved. It's actually the technology that's put into it. You know, like, why is the NBA score so high? Because they change the rules.
Change the rules and
you know what I mean? Like, you can't be in the keyway. You can't do this. Now we're better. No, we're not better. We just change the rules so it's more suitable to make that happen. Like, so again,
but you can't argue overall there's more better because there's more people, it's a more global
more population,
game.
You get more of the height, you know, but the percentage is the same, I guess.
That's also why they have to change it. It's, again, to me, NBA, everything, it's more like entertainment.
Yeah.
I actually stopped watching NBA.
You stopped watching?
I stopped watching NBA because I actually think it's just too much of a show. Like, obviously, they're excellent athletes.
And skillful.
They're doing things that most of us probably won't be able to do. But again, to me right now, is I like to watch basketball at levels where I know not me can reach, but some of the elite athletes, like probably you guys could reach. But again, I'm kind of like trying to find opportunities for players. NBA, it's, to me, it's just like way too far right now. So I kind of, I don't know, I stopped watching NBA.
Okay. Yeah, I understand why. And I'm glad you mentioned that because that is what you do. You try to offer people opportunities. Explain what BSBL is. Explain what you've been doing basketball-wise
the past. Yeah, it's probably a good lead way to bring me in talk about BSBL.
Yeah, what is BSBL?
Obviously, BSBL stands for Brisbane South Baskteball League.
Yes, sir.
So previously, we're actually called BYBL. And before that, it's actually called UCBL. We started out with a church group.
When was that? Church.
It's just an outdoor, random outdoor court.
2000 and...
Whoa. Way, way back. It's probably like 15,
wait, your way back and like our way back, his way back is way different.
So what's 2015? This guy.
Let's say 40.
Fucking last
that
year.
That was like
yesterday.
15 years ago. I can't remember.
So it's almost that Tam's long. Whole age.
Yeah. Yeah, there you go. Now we started our UCBL, like playing outdoors. We'll worry about the weather. We'll worry about this and that. But it's literally just a bunch of people, Asians back then as well, just love playing basketball.
Do you have any of the originals still there?
Yeah.
A couple of the players, yes.
Who?
Andy actually, Andy Chan.
Yeah, I believe
he should
that.
Be on the show right now.
Should be here. Andy's messed up, Andy. Yes.
Under 16.
No, what funny was.
Under 16? You coached him?
Under 16 state. No, I just remember when he played. Okay. Yeah. When he was a kid.
And Tim, is it Tim?
With the glasses.
Nah. He's Oscar's brother, right?
Eric. He wasn't in at the first group of people.
Oh, okay.
So the church actually started out by Ivan, one of my friends.
Okay.
And me and my brother was like, well, he needs help, like running this. Like even though back then it was only four teams, all right? But me and my brother, along with Ivan, we were helping. Okay. We got the league together. We were playing outdoors, like preparing for championship, like medals and everything.
Mm.
And it just grew. And we decided to move indoors. But Ivan decided to do med. That's the difference. Like, life goes on. Like, growing up, moved on, passed it on to his brother, Kevin.
Okay.
We renamed it called BYBL.
And why did you do that?
Guess what Y stands for?
Youth.
Brisbane.
Oh, you got it.
Sorry.
I was going to get there, bro. Yeah. Like, fucking hell.
Oh, no, Akira. A little suspense. No, actually, yeah, back then, again, we're talking about 15, 16 years ago, like when most of us were still...
When you were youth. Yeah.
But obviously, why we change it to Brisbane South Basketball League right now is we no longer youth anymore.
No youth anymore.
Me, just evolved.
Evolved more, yes. so we call Brisbane South Basketball.
You can go men's.
BSBL works.
BS, it does roll off better. Yeah. BM, yeah, you're right. BM doesn't
start. So anyway, that's where we're from. We started from four teams, like I said, outdoor, moving indoor to 12, now was 44. 44, 46 or 48, I can't even remember.
48 teams now.
Something like that, like 400 or 500 players.
You know, when you come into it, when I came into it, I just assumed this was already a thing.
Yeah.
And so, I never really, until you started telling me more, and like, I just assume it's always had been there at Logan. I just assume
it was
every
like
Sunday.
Callumbell.
You started, okay.
Yeah,
outdoor court, and then Callumbell
school. And then the reason why I moved from Callumbell to Canubia is because I'm starting to get elite players like you guys. And apparently all the elite players telling me, oh, those like rubbery surfaces,
it's not good.
It's not good for your knees, ankles, blah blah blah. I don't know whether
real
it's
elite
just
players.
You know,
real elite players. We put ourselves through. You man, know, just you like whatever floor.
Yeah.
Haven't played an outdoor court in years.
So for me, like to improve the league, getting more elite players coming on board and all that, I just went on searching, and luckily Canubia.
Bro, you are a great recruiter.
I love it, actually. I like, love doing
you
this.
You come to training and you see Han standing like this, watching. I'm like, he's up to something.
I'm just thinking. Like, every time I see players, I was like, oh, they're doing something. All right, yeah.
Just wants to make it better. Like, I just think anyone who's passionate, like...
He's very passionate.
Well, there's four teams and they got medals and they're running it like it's professional from the start.
Yeah.
Because of the passion and the love. And that's what I love about it is, like, even though I went to BYBL and then went to BSBL, it's like, how do I keep improving this league? Mm. And that's because we love it. And, you know, I think that that's something that lacks sometimes. I think that, you know, it becomes about other associations might become about money or might become about, you know, like prestige or this or that, whereas this is just how we just make this better.
Well, eventually it's going to be about the money. He's going to move out of here. Go back, get a little farm.
The problem is that, like, you think that, but the problem is right now is Han keeps reinvesting that money into the league. So that's the other thing. He's not making any money.
Why don't you take care of yourself?
Well, no, again, well, we started out being a non-profit league, and I still believe, like, it's a non-profit. Like, I'm fortunate that I have a job, a steady job, a hard one, but it pays.
McDonald's don't pay that much. What are they paying now?
Science, I'm not sure. Science.
You're a scientist.
You're
a research scientist. Yeah, okay.
Scientist, man.
Scientists, yeah, it's
trying to like cure cancer and stuff, right? For real, heart disease and
heart disease and stroke.
Yeah, let's stick with it. You're trying to really cure some.
Yeah, shit. Wish Jarrett will be here backing me up. Science is not the best paid job, but it's probably one of the toughest and long hour jobs.
You could have gone to Harvard. Where's Jarrett?
Jared.
Cool, Jared.
I'm not like the top in the class like Kim. I actually did go through most of your podcast.
Oh, you did with him?
Yeah.
You found out that he was like a super insecure guy. He just needs to reassure people that he's smart, but
I know.
He really doesn't fully believe it.
Could have gone to Ivy League, but didn't even try.
Just special. For me, it's like I have a job that pays and I'm happy. But I do believe not everyone is that fortunate. And if I can create a non-profit league where I do have a group of people that also believe in this idea, I do have an admin team of
around
15 of us who are willing to come and sacrifice their Sunday right now and get the league up and running. And I think this influenced a lot of people. And I got you guys, or I got him. KB. Especially
KB
that changed BSBL completely. Like we
having a white guy around.
Yeah, essentially, you need to. I knew the system. I knew my way around the system.
Yeah,
I just needed to help Han see it for what it was.
Yeah.
No, it was. I mean, my thing is that when Han.
Nah, bro, I'm really funny. I gotta say that. Come on, man. I need my credit.
Press the thing.
Yeah, I don't need the thing. Hello. Pat myself.
I like it. Okay. Straight face. So you just got a white guy in? Is that what you needed? Damn straight.
Everything changed.
Got a white guy in. Now it's about money.
Yeah, it's about money. About, like, it's not a non-profit anymore. Was that his idea?
That was the first thing.
That's have been his idea, right?
Nah, the thing is like... When I talked to Han, like, we were on the same page about trying to provide opportunities for people and for anyone who actually wanted to work hard and was passionate about it. And you don't find a lot of people like that in basketball. You don't find a lot of people who will do things for people to help them have opportunities. And so, when we talked, that was a no-brainer for me. And then I just tried to find people who also shared that. They would like opportunities. And it's a slow process, but... The league has changed a lot in the last 5 years or whatever in terms of the level of players coming in. So the competitions are much higher, where week in, week out are much higher. And then obviously the national competitions we play. So the
national competitions, that was so fun, man.
Yeah, that's a NBL one level. And then, once we get back in, after COVID, we go international, then that's a whole nother level. So...
It takes a certain person to want to be a part of it, in my opinion, because most people want to come to something that's already built.
That is true.
Have you been getting around that? How do you, like, convince people, yo, come play here? Like, have free opportunity.
I don't know. I think sometimes, like I said to Kieran yesterday, I think sometimes as a leader, even though I don't see myself as a leader, I keep on telling my team that everyone's equal. I just have more responsibility because I'm leading you guys. But don't call me a leader. Like every one of you guys, because we're in it together.
Yeah.
All right. We can make decisions together.
But you're an example leader too.
Yes, but at the end they kind of just push me and that you can do all the talking and do this. And I actually love it. I love talking.
But you do the reffing. You ref as well.
You do the everything.
GoPro, so they video all the games with GoPro. Han's doing the GoPro. He's doing the reffing. He'll like everything. So
I do it because again I do want to lead by example. That I'm out there to do everything, and I hope you can follow as well. I'm not paying myself for anything, and I hope if you believe in it and believe in the system or the league that we have, and like just offering, and to people that probably will benefit, then let's do this together. And I am fortunate that we do have like probably say 15 of the admins that believe in this idea.
That believe in
helping out.
Yeah, like it's really cool to see everyone just and the support they have for you, the way everybody speaks about you is look, you're already trying to deflect. Like you don't want to take any compliments. You don't want to like.
No, I appreciate it. But
he
again,
appreciate it.
No, yeah. But the thing is, like again, I can't do this all by myself.
Yeah, for sure.
Like, it's a whole that. Like I credit everyone. That. It's a team thing. And yeah, like to me, I feel like everyone could have done it if they really want to. Like, if just whether you get put
you think
into
so?
That position,
you think so?
You develop. I wasn't like this at when I was. What?
That's what people say when they do amazing things.
No.
They anyone, all say that shit. Yo.
Anyone could have done this.
Yeah.
Like, all you have to do is work hard 8 hours
like
a day.
Right now?
Like no, that's what Kobe says. Kobe says anyone can do it. You just need to get up at 4 a.m. Yeah. Work 2 hours and then go again at 10,
go
and then
nap,
go again
back.
At 3, and then go again at 6. You do that every day for 20 years, you'll be as good as me.
It's light.
And it's true, Han. It's true. Anyone could do it if you did what you did.
But they don't.
No one does. So
I think it's opportunity as
it's
well.
It's not opportunity, Han.
I don't know. For me, I feel like because I wasn't like
maybe
this.
That's there's something there.
Yeah, okay. I wasn't like this when I grew up. Like, my mom still knows me as that shy person that would not talk to people, especially girls.
Mm.
I was like, but in science, you're surrounded by girls.
Really?
Hold up.
You're picking the wrong field.
Hold up. How do I get into science?
Tell me about science.
There you go.
Tell
you're picking science. The wrong field.
Huh? Tell me.
No,
tell
science
me.
Is how? You're surrounded by girls, all right? I've put myself
intelligent
there.
Girls.
Intelligent girls.
They're really
okay, so
there.
what university degree are you talking about?
Be specific. What field?
Help out our people.
Help our people out, man. These guys want to... I didn't want to say what I was about to say. Let me relax.
These people want to study.
Well, yeah.
They want to turn up to the right classes, improve their minds. What classes are you talking about?
Yeah.
It's just basic research, medical research. That's what I'm doing at UQ right now.
Oh, you at UQ?
I'm at UQ. I
tried to tell you, Tim. I tried to tell you.
I finished my postgraduate.
What was your undergraduate
degree? Applied science, apparently.
Applied science?
Major in biotech.
Biotechnology, yeah.
Yeah. I didn't even pick that originally. I was going to...
A lot of beautiful...
My dad actually wanted me to do engineer.
Yeah.
But...
It's no girls in engineering.
Fuck.
No, luckily, boys.
All boys.
No,
like,
my dad wanted to...
And Han was like, I see what you're saying, Dad, but I'll see you at the biotech.
Going to biotech.
No, because I actually apply randomly. I picked science for some reason. My dad asked me to go and do... engineer.
Yeah.
I went to the school and asked whether I can change. I said, well, the semester has already started. You can change next semester. I said, okay, I'll come back again. And then my dad seriously set me down and said, so actually, all right, now that you cannot change, what are you actually studying? I said, well, biotech.
Huh.
And back in the days, at least, I'm from Taiwan, by the way.
Okay.
So you're studying in Taiwan at this stage?
No. I moved to New Zealand when I was 8.
So you study in New Zealand?
I study in New Zealand, and then I moved here when year 11.
Okay,
No, I did my undergrad here in Australia.
In UQ?
QT.
QT.
And then I did my master's.
Not a bad.
QT's okay.
Yeah. Not and a bad. I did my master's
Gardens Point. Gardens Point is beautiful.
Gardens Point. I hear Gardens
Point. A lot
Point's
of great
nice.
Restaurants there.
No. Exactly.
And then my dad asked me, and back then in Taiwan, all the news, like Baltech, it's booming.
Yeah.
All right, they're saying, oh, it's one of the best.
So he saw opportunity for
he
you.
He saw an opportunity. I was like, oh, damn, you're in biotech? Or I stay in biotech.
Huh.
I stayed. And to this day, 18, 19 years I've worked, I still think people, they got tricked.
What do you mean?
Science is not that easy. You might see the flashy news as I saw some pharmaceutical
who the
company.
Who thought that?
No, trust me.
Who are you hanging around, bro?
You'll see,
this
like,
is what we were talking about last time. Yeah. Who you hang around, the expectations would be really different. Who the told you science is like easy? And like
pharmaceutical, they release something. We found this drug. Oh, this lab, like this researcher found this. Now they're like probably millionaires.
They get glorified, yes.
Yeah, yeah.
How many are out there? Like people spend 20, 30, 40 years doing something without any success.
Yeah.
And yeah, it's just, but my dad, because of the news.
Your dad got tricked.
My dad got tricked.
Oh, okay.
And he got me tricked.
He tricked you because he thought that, you know, you could be a billionaire.
Yeah. So
how close are you though? How close are you? How many
I'm
years?
Not even close.
Until he's rich.
Yeah. Until
later. And then BSBL, that's when we lived.
Yeah, maybe.
But no, but
so you did an undergraduate degree, QT. Yeah, finished that, and then
I did my master's at UQ.
In what?
Biotech.
So now you're at UQ. So you must have done well at QT. Jump into your master's at UQ.
I did okay. Not great.
But good study groups. You were like.
Were there study groups back then? Science study groups.
Good groups.
No, actually, as soon as I finished, I went back home. I studied myself. I did not even
smart.
So boring ass.
My uni days were boring.
When did you find out that there was girls in science?
Yeah.
I did not until I started working.
Oh, so tell us.
Oh, so it's
bit.
Different as a student and as a faculty.
Well, as a student, because as soon as
you're
I finished,
yeah.
I went back home.
You went home.
I went home and studied.
Oh, so now you're doing late nights at the
did
at
you
the
do
research.
PhD? Did you do a PhD?
I just jumped straight in.
So you did a master's and then you started working.
I just started working. Because I never wanted to do a PhD.
In Taiwan?
No, over here.
Oh.
I never studied in Taiwan.
So
I moved out.
So
when
did you,
I was
so there. You just jumped straight into a lab?
Yeah.
And that's when you found...
like, there were all the girls.
Good
people to talk to.
Yeah.
There's people to talk to, yeah.
We don't have to talk in secret, can he? Yeah, he's all the girls.
All the girls.
Yeah, we don't have to do that no more.
All the girls. First lab, like, there's probably like 20 of us. I think there's like two guys.
No.
Two or three guys.
They had great numbers.
Yeah, there you go.
Even a Tim could have a chance.
Man, even a guy like me.
Tim's thinking,
you're in the wrong field.
My guy's the opposite, bro.
My ratio could be great.
Yeah,
I remember I think like in a lab of 20 people, we might have two guys. And we're talking about...
Reminds me of psychology. Psychology, there was 200 students and five guys in it. Undergraduate degree.
There you go.
I remember rocking up the psychology undergraduate and going, there's no guys here. I mean, I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't know where
and I don't know what's going on over there. I need help.
I need to sit right there.
I need help. I mean,
what are you doing? I don't know what I'm doing.
What are we doing?
That was, I remember, first year.
So were you still a shy person at this time? And what's going through your mind?
You're forced to talk.
You're forced. Science makes you talk.
Okay.
There you go. And then started talking. But I think the real talking started about basketball. It's like...
With the girls?
Not with the girls, with the guys. And then I learned through work how important it is to talk and network.
Okay.
And that's so when everything started...
Networking.
With
just the guys, right? Of course. With just the
did you start networking?
Basketball is for guys.
So, but how did you network with the female researchers?
Scientists.
Scientists. How do you network with them?
It just
came naturally.
Yeah.
Look, I don't really remember
I've
the
never
details.
Seen you shrug your shoulders in my life.
You're doing the Jordan.
Yeah, the Jordan shrug.
That was Dang Dang today. I remember the game. He's like,
I don't know.
He had 50. I don't know.
50. I do this.
No, well, yeah, they come to you and ask questions, and obviously you answer. You answer back.
Smartest guy in the room.
Professionally.
Smartest guy in the room.
The workforce.
What about coffee? Like, you don't go get coffee, still professional. Let's skip this. Tell me about when you wanted to take it outside of the profession, or you wanted to get to know one of the researchers more, if you've done that at one point in your life. And you know what I mean? Do you know what I'm saying? Like,
because scientists seem hard to approach.
Yeah. And you're in the professional setting, so it's like, how do you take their...
You're in a workplace.
Is it the right side of the brain that's like super logical? I don't know.
You're like, really? And as a scientist, the easy way to talk to people, you collaborate, you ask what they do. And then you explain what you do, maybe how you can help each other out.
So you show interest in the other person.
Yes.
See what they're all about. They show interest in you. And then you sort of collaborate about how and you might you be able
talking,
to
work together.
Start. Work together.
I'm not talking about work, though. I'm not trying to talk about
neither
work.
Neither are we. Neither are we.
I'm the slow one. Oh, shit. I'm trying to get the...
you know, you get caught up. I just talked about myself for 45 minutes.
Yeah, that's all I do.
And so what do you think?
So, and then the percentages aren't good. The percentages are really low right
The girls are like, that's great.
Cool.
I need to get back to work.
You do a podcast? All right. Fuck.
Why don't you ask me about... Why don't you ask one thing about me? No, I'm good. I just want to know what you thought about
me.
Explain yourself what you do. Girls dig it.
Where do you take a researcher out for a date?
If... A
researcher out for a date?
Yeah.
If...
A date.
Oh, a date? Where?
Because you have a partner at the moment, right?
Yeah, I do have.
And how long have you been with her for?
Sheesh, my fault. I didn't know this. Was that being disrespectful?
No. I just want to go back to it. But
yeah, let's go. Okay.
So is she a researcher?
Yes.
Oh,
so you did it.
No, we met.
That's what the struggles were.
We met during masters in class.
That's even better.
Huh. Yeah. Like, I think we were supposed to having exams or something. I think I just walked up and say, you guys studied. And just like that. And then we started
this talking. Shy guy, never talked to anybody, just walked up, just said, hey, do you study? They're like, yeah, do you study? Like, yeah, let's study together. And the rest is history.
They were watching him the whole time.
That's it.
Did you ever ask your partner, like, did you look at me before I ever came and said hi?
No, I don't think she looked at me. I looked at her. No, I don't think she looked at me. But again, it's in a class, in an auditorium of, I don't know, it's like 200 people.
Are you new?
Well, I think she was late. I was just looking
at her. I'm pretty sure she's late on week three, session two.
Yeah, she's not that serious about her.
Late, and then, yeah,
this is my kind of girl. She doesn't care about time.
Yeah, anyway, I hope she doesn't hear all this.
I hope she does, because you're a... You go for what you want, which is actually very cool.
Thank you.
That's like very...
And
like,
you chose early, right? What happened then? So you met her in Masters.
And we just started talking.
Where'd you take her out? Dating-wise. Did you go coffee clubs? Did you?
We don't drink coffee.
Ah, what do you drink? Vodka.
No. I actually don't drink alcohol as well. I'm a boring guy.
Where did you go? Yes, I know that feeling. Where did you go? Brazilian?
I don't know.
Seems like you guys are winning, though. It's boring, guys. What the hell, bro?
It's boring.
This boring thing might work.
I'm wealthy and happy, but I'm really boring.
I don't know. We've been together like 18, 19 years.
Yeah.
Wow,
I can't even remember.
That's awesome. Our
first outing.
Oh, wow.
Well, yes,
I hope she doesn't hear that.
No, I was going to say, you probably don't say that.
Yeah, don't. That's not what you're supposed to
say. You don't say that.
You've been hanging out with Jared too much. don't say the wrong things.
But anyway, yes, I was fortunate. Met the one and...
Yeah. Going steady.
For 20 years.
That is awesome, man. Far out, that is awesome.
I love how new age you are. Because, you know, you don't want to be tied down by marriage or any of these modern conventions.
You moved here early. You moved to, sorry,
moved
to
New Zealand, to New Zealand early.
What's the culture?
Came over here 15.
Do you have a strong cultural, like, Is your cultural
links to Taiwan?
I'm sure you have links, but is it like not a burden? Is it a big
expectation?
Yeah, to just answer the question. I don't know what I'm asking.
He's asking, like, you know how like the Taiwanese have a really big community here.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you moved here since you were young. Do you have that?
Just gotta do this. I think I just gotta do those. Yeah.
No, or yes and no, I think. I think because I moved out when I was 8, so I always hang out with English-speaking people.
White people?
Both. No, in New Zealand, actually.
New Zealanders.
Maoris. Islanders. Yeah, cool. White people.
White people.
Well, white people are everywhere. Yeah, everywhere.
White people are trained every aspect of the world.
It's like...
No, literally.
You know that virus? You know how viruses... COVID. Well, you know science. You know
white people are like that.
Like that.
They're gonna kill you eventually.
No, I'm not going to comment. Eventually. On this. I don't know.
That's a great answer. That's the best answer you had all night.
I've got a job.
Like you lose this here.
Say whatever you want. You're unique. You don't have a real job. I've got a real job, and there's only so much you can say.
but I'm comfortable. Like, yes, Taiwan, my home. I am linked, but because I moved out when I was so young, like English speaking, it's natural to us. So going up to someone speaking English, it's fine. I only hang out with my own race.
Like now, how much of an influence is your culture compared to
in what you're doing
and how you make decisions? Decisions with wifey, decisions with your job, decisions with
work. I think it probably still influence because at the end, like, because your parents do influence you.
Right, like you said, your dad has a huge influence on you, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so is that still...
They probably still, like, treat you and ask you to do certain things like quite an Asian, typical Asian would do.
Mm-hmm.
But then I have to re-educate my mom, for example.
Mm-hmm.
I know that's not how things done over here, and like, I want her to understand.
Mm-hmm.
But again, I do understand everything. I see it from both sides. Why she's coming and telling me to do this way? Maybe there's for the good or for the bad. Like yeah, so I kind of like I just need to process everything myself. Pardon? Yeah, look at all aspects.
Huh? Did you get a chance to look at that book that I gave you?
No,
of course. Sorry. Of course not.
What book is it?
It's called Fortunate Sons. I think I explained it to you a little bit.
Say the whole China was...
Yeah, well, they sent... what is it?
I remember you telling me that there was like four families that literally kind of like started out...
No, okay, so they sent, at the time, they had this big initiative to be like, this one guy goes, he was the first Chinese student to get accepted into an Ivy League school, right? So he goes, he's in Massachusetts, I think it was Harvard, and he had such a struggle being there as one of the first, you know, as the first Chinese student in an American world, mm-hmm. that when he finally got through it and learned so much about, you know, how the Americans work, his whole thing was to come back and, you know, connect those cultures. And so his thing was they sent 100 students, like young kids, to Massachusetts to go study. And the whole goal was for them to get that side, the American side of how they do things, so that they can come back to China and be the leaders of the revolution, you know. And I just thought that's why I sent it to you and him, that these guys were thinking in generations. And his whole thing was like, yo, we need to not leave the traditions, but like kind of be open to new ideas, like tech. Totally. You were like, yo, like we have no factories here where instead of just getting guns from them, we need to know how to manufacture our own stuff. We need to know how to, you know, get into engineering and science and
all this. Yeah, learning each other's culture.
But he was like, we have to go do that there because here the shackles were there's too much influence. Mm-hmm. And I just thought it was so cool that, like, they were thinking that far ahead, and it fucking worked. Like, it fucking worked, you know? Like I think, I don't know, but China might be the most technologically advanced empire in the fucking world. Right? I know. So obviously, yeah, Japan's there too, but, like, he had to, and he went through a lot. That's why the book was so cool. He went through a lot. The kids who went over there went through a lot. Even when they came back, they were shunned, most of them, because, like, you guys aren't really part of us. Yeah, you know, you guys are too Americanized now. Yeah. You can't come work with us.
What's it
we
called?
Do things this way. Fortunate Sons. The Fortunate Sons. And so now there's a bunch of schools in this guy's name. Why?
The Fortunate Sons.
Everyone's getting their phone. Should I be taking it out?
No, Google has gone so bad.
I'm trying to type it in so I can.
Google has gone so bad.
Yeah, I'll look at it later.
Anyway.
Yeah, you should have got your phone out. That would be cool. Podcasting with phones. Yeah, I mean, the idea is awesome. Like, how do you change the world if you don't introduce something outside of the system?
Yeah.
Because the system's self-perpetuating. Everyone gets involved in their own little world. And I think that's something that we're trying to do with BSBL is trying to create something alternate on the side so that people have other options, and then maybe we can, give people opportunities that are keen to do that in other areas. So
yeah, well, we're based in Australia, but it doesn't mean that we cannot approach teams or like from Asia continent.
Exactly.
And Asia, even use some of what they're doing. Yeah. Apply it here and exactly. Make it better.
Yeah, yeah.
So
just stealing everything from everyone and, you know.
And just use it for your
own.
And
then you make yourself better. Like, that's the idea.
That's the idea.
But that's why I brought it up, because you guys are doing something new. You're doing something that's outside of the convention of what's going on here. Mm-hmm. For you to start in whatever, 15 years ago, 2015 or whatever.
15, yeah, something like that. Have
you ever felt like not doing it? I want to know about that.
No, I have not actually given any thought.
Ever?
Not at the moment. I have been tired. But again, why I want to do it is because, again, it's a whole history. Like, I have to go back to New Zealand. Why even? Because my dad built a basketball hoop at the backyard for me.
Okay.
And literally, I was there hooping
all day.
Every day.
Yep.
New Zealand, I think, like, during summer, you get daylight to, like, 9 p.m. or even later.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll just be there hooping. Mm-hmm. And because I have a basketball hoop, I get to invite all my friends over.
Mm-hmm.
I'm, like, the man. Like, everyone's coming to me, like, to my house and play, and I'm loving it. But when I moved over here, the high school I went to, there weren't a lot of, I don't know. It's just different. All right. I tried to fit in.
They weren't ballers.
That purely because Brisbane, when I first moved here, it was so bloody hot. During lunchtime, back in New Zealand, we'll be balling. Over here, everyone's under the shade. No, I don't want to
school
go.
School did you go to?
Redeemer.
Yeah. Redeemer College. Redeemer. Maris College Redeemer.
What a Redeemer.
Is that it? Maris College Redeemer? Is it not? Is this Redeemer?
Lutheran,
okay.
College.
It's the old name.
Around Rochdale.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, so people don't want to ball. And then I'm by myself. I was like, well, if no one wants to ball with me, or I might as well hang out with my friend. Let's not ball.
Mm.
And I think that's why I became like really shy. Like, again, I continue to stay within my own shell, like not talking, not reaching out to people.
Yeah.
It's until Ivan, who started this UCBL, and I have more responsibility, and I start connecting with people.
Yeah.
and he has given me so much.
Yeah.
And where I am at right now, like, happy to come to the show, talk to you guys.
Yeah, wish
that. So I just want to give something back. Like, it's like I started because of basketball, and I want to give something back. So for net, like, so far, I've like, yeah, I'll
believe just going. Yeah,
I just want to continue on. It has been tiring, like, work, try to juggle work and basketball, like, trying to get together. Like, before, if it's just the league, it's easy. But we're not just talking about league anymore. We're talking about, like, interstate, involving with exhibition games here and there. People look at me and say, oh, when are we going to have trainings? Referees look at me and say, oh, what's this, what's that? And do referee course for upcoming players who wants to become referees. It's getting massive. It's tiring, but again, I'm enjoying it.
That's inspiring,
it's,
bro.
It's giving me a lot of joy. Cool, and it's like, yeah, hanging out every Sunday so far, hanging out with you guys, everyone, literally. It's just, I love it. Yeah.
Well, you're a cheater, but we won't get into that.
Why? What do you mean?
You know he cheats, right? Every finals.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
The Olympics.
How you be a GM, a ref? You really do everything.
Yeah, yeah,
GM,
yeah.
He doing the scoreboard and reffing at the same time.
The rules change.
Like, bro.
Eligibility rules, like, just changed out again.
There's no minimum games required for the finals. So there's a new guy, like some NBL guy rocking up for Olympic. Exactly. And it's cool, bro.
Oh, man. We had a little extra cash left over.
Cool, bro.
I get accused of this so much.
It's cool, bro.
No, the thing is, Olympians, we went through a phase where we have to rebuild. It's like literally we have to rebuild, and I managed. And that's why you see me there standing and looking at guys. I'm constantly thinking, oh, this guy could make my team much better. I need a guy that plays like this at this position.
He's the most passionate guy out there. He's looking to rebuild all the time. Oh, like, they deserve everything they get.
Yeah. And all these players, I was like, oh, man, if I can get him to BSBL, wouldn't it be great? And I actually don't get players to come and play for Olympians. I've been introducing players else to other teams. I want to make the league.
Yeah, all right. Yeah, all right, buddy. Okay. Yeah, you're really good, man. You are really good at what you do. I love it, man.
We'll see you guys.
So how can we
win? Turn up. What?
No, I can't.
Nothing. Nothing. Every time I turn up, you know,
you win.
Usually you win, but you know.
Now get the game. Get everyone.
I do want to get everyone, and no one wants to.
That's the problem.
That's the whole thing. If we're going to cap this on any, if there's a theme of this, is you could provide as much opportunity
as you want.
And
with interstate competition, international opportunities.
I swear
you can offer all of that.
It seems like God's been putting me in a position with guys that are in that position.
Yeah.
Pause. But guys who are in the position that they want more opportunities. Hey, I'm not getting a call here, NBL one.
They say they want opportunities.
So I'd be like, oh, well, what do you know?
Here's
an opportunity. I play on Sundays at this this league, BSBL. You know, you should come play. Oh, yeah, that thing over there, I think I've seen. Like, bro, show up. There's going to be, like, we play in Melbourne. There might be a tour. Yeah. There's opportunities where people are watching. You know what I mean? Like from leagues over there. And they're like, okay, cool. You know, I'll let you know.
Never turn up.
Never get nothing.
And so it's not.
If they turn up, they'll turn up once.
Yeah.
And maybe see it's not what they expected. Or even if they like it, they just won't come back.
Yep.
Consistently.
And it's almost like when you make it possible, they don't want it.
They don't.
They want to be told, oh, yes, yeah, but they want to be lied to. Really want you.
Yeah.
And then get cut. We really, really want you and then get cut. Whereas the difference is, and that's what I found, is like when you actually provide opportunities and you remove all the excuses away for people and you actually provide these pathways and these things and they actually have to sit there and do the work, the work's not being done. The
work's not, they don't want to.
So you can only offer the opportunities and see what people want.
So how can we, me personally, and I want you and Kieran to maybe not do it on camera, but do it on camera. How can we amplify? You already said there's a lot of work to do, but how can we amplify besides just keep showing up? How can I help more? How can KB help more?
Well, Kieran's already helping a lot.
Kieran's already helping a lot of Tim.
This motherfucker just shows up, walks around, gets views, like, all right, helping. All right.
Buddy. Each week, how many messages are messaged him? Kieran, I need this. Oh, when can we have training? Are you available for this? Are you available? No, I'm grateful that I met you guys, like especially Kieran.
Like, I'm not doing enough. Like, I know I'm not doing enough, and I want to be able to do more, and that's something that I want to do in the future. And I think, I want to work towards that. Obviously, with the tours and even come back on Sundays and all those kind of things. I think that's something that I want to work into. Definitely, I'm going to try to be more involved once AFL finishes in a couple of weeks. So I want to be back and doing that and start playing next year. So that's what my plan is. Mm-hmm. I think that, again, the only way to get people involved is see if we can keep lifting the standard of the competition and see if we can get people to train and get better and, mm-hmm. you know, value it for what it is and, you know, move forward.
You guys have the connections. I kind of, like, rely on you guys when you go out there and ball. Let people know about
I don't talk to people, but I'm going to start doing that. Well, I'm going to start.
Well, you got to talk to the right
I'll
people.
Try. Yeah, I'll try.
You need to talk to the right
people. We're actually talking to a lot of people.
Yeah.
People just don't appreciate it because they think that, well, I don't know what they think, but they don't appreciate it for what it is.
Yeah, some people don't, but that is a muscle I'll try to exercise, you know.
Yeah, like, yeah, make the change. Like, it's never too late.
Mm. Yeah. You got to look at the man in the mirror before you make a change.
Okay. That's perfect.
That's right. Man, that was thanks for being here, man. And sharing your story and
I appreciate it.
And all this cool stuff.
Finally make time.
I know how I'm gonna help
you guys.
In my way to help is to just win. And definitely. Keep winning. We're gonna win this next one. I'm calling it now. You tell everybody. Well, tell Andy, all of them, yo. I'm coming for the championship.
Well, I don't even know where the Olympians will be.
Have you seen the rings?
I haven't seen them.
Actually,
well, the last time we won, we didn't get any.
They're ridiculous. No, the rings for the BSBL.
That's what I'm saying. Last time we won, we didn't get any.
We haven't won.
We won the Easter tournament.
Yeah, have you seen the rings for the...
I haven't seen. Are they serious?
They're like massive, like...
Can we win then?
I showed you pictures. You didn't turn up to the semi.
Oh, shit.
I'm like, all right, we got this.
Hey, I was busy, man.
Yeah, nah, man, I can't make it.
This was like 2 years ago. Where was this?
I know.
Oh, okay. Yeah, at the Nissan? Yeah. I was busy that weekend, I think.
It was busy.
It was a Sunday? 2 years ago?
2 years
two
ago.
2 years ago. I was busy on Sundays.
You weren't the most reliable person.
2023.
That's this year's one. Mm. I'm still modifying a few things, but that's like...
That's awesome, man. Oh, this look legit. What is the P?
Well, it's our sponsor.
Okay.
Plantation Homes. Okay. Actually, shout out to them. Thank you very much.
Okay, that's awesome. What do they do? Plantation
Homes. Realty, the builders.
Okay.
Yeah, but it's like legit. Like it's...
No, that's fire, man. Yeah, I want that. That you is, I'm going to claim that right now. I'm going to put that vibration out there. We're claiming that.
I know. I see
Yo,
that.
St. James, Leo, let's get our shit together, man.
Nah, yeah, no, serious. Get the boys.
You know, the last time I played, because I was so fed up with everyone, I called 4-flat every play, unless it was a fast break.
Oh, did you watch the NBL 1 final?
Oh, no, nah, I didn't watch.
Dang.
He was just going to work?
He went 8 of 14 from 3. Yeah, and just went to work. Like that's what you need to be for us to win.
I'm not passing shit. I'm treating, like, every time I play now on Sundays, yeah, I'm treating it like I want to see what I can do.
Yeah,
that's what I'm treating it as, actually.
No, that,
I want to see if I can score a lot again. Like, I haven't scored a lot in a long time.
Taking a lot of shots.
Yeah, I mean, fucking taking a lot of shots. They haven't been like, going in,
it's
man.
It's just like,
so
you're
like,
just like shooting.
I'm trying to figure out how to get the ball to get going the hoop
sounds
again.
Like life.
You need to get the ball in the hoops in order to beat Olympians. Let's put it this way.
You need to learn to put the ball in the hoop in order to get what you want.
Hun. All right, bro.
There you go.
No, it's all good. It's all good. We're getting our stuff together.
All right, that's fantastic. No, I.
That's fantastic. Right, that's really cool.
No, but
that's,
what I'm trying to say.
Wait, after the final, you got to come back.
Yeah, you got to
come
back.
Yeah, you got to come in with a happy or sad face. So you better come here.
Oh man, you're like sprinkle salt on my wound.
I'm going to do that. Man. I'm going to sprinkle.
Oh, I'm sprinkling soda on your wound. Now, there's a lot of talented teams. Every team so far in Div 1, there's like 8 teams. Everyone's saying, we're coming for you guys.
For your team?
For my team. Like, every one of them saying.
I love that because no one is thinking about us at all, which is great. It's great. And you know, unfortunately, every time, I'm sorry for coming late every week, man. It's in my genes. It's in my genes. But you know, I think last time we came late, it was down like, you know, they put extra points. Gave us like 25. It sucks, yeah. But you know, we still end up winning by like 10 or something. So it was like a 35-point turnaround.
Humble brag.
But it was cool. We're just gonna try to stop coming late, you know.
Not be down by so much.
Yeah, not be down. I mean, we usually can come bring it back, but
you know. That game, you, Renko, and everyone, had a crazy Jew, had a crazy game. But again, that's when we don't have half of our NBL 1 players around as well. So it'll be nice. No, what I want is a final where it is like NBL 1.
We'll make it fully timed.
Fully timed, yeah. That'll be awesome, actually.
Yeah, I'll make it fully timed. See, I'm changing rules.
That's the next step.
I'm changing
rules. Yeah, we'll just keep building, and I think...
I know you've been changing rules for a long time. How are you going to tell me that? I know you have.
It's like the NBA.
Yeah. Entertainment, huh?
It's all about entertainment. Sales BSBL, where I can get sponsors to sponsor us. I can take you guys out. That's what I'm doing.
If you could get someone who could dunk...
We used to have one. Etienne used to come dunk. He's moved to Sydney and shit. But he actually brought a lot of excitement.
Contests in 3-point contests or something.
Yeah, but it would bring excitement if you had some people who could destroy down.
Could actually really, really dunk.
That would be good. Yeah, hype up the atmosphere like that.
I won't be involved in the dunk contest, but I'll be there cheering. I'm just there to win, man. That's it. Any final thoughts, KB? Any final?
My final thoughts are, I think if you start something with the right intention, the philosophy behind it, try to make people better and provide opportunities, then, you know, it just keeps growing and building. And that's what Han's done. Four teams into, over 600 members. And I think, it's still going strong just because people love to ball and love the atmosphere. So I think that's really, really cool and it's excellent to be a part of.
Yeah. What I want to say, if you're involved in something that you're really passionate, you attract a lot of people have similar passion like you guys. And then, once everyone put their strengths together, synergy, we can do something great.
We can do it. Appreciate that, bro. Well, I want to get into research. I want to attract some researchers to help me research, science research. Yeah, I want to get into that. I'm switching from engineering. I'm just going to follow you. I'm not doing engineering anymore. I'm now a scientist.
are you sure?
You said there's good people in the industry.
Always like biology.
No, there's a lot of smart and good people in there.
Smart, good people. Yeah. And I want to change the world.
Fantastic, but it's
hard. Stick with engineering.
I keep on telling my
student. You look like
more
like an engineering guy.
you should stick with engineering.
Look, I'm in charge of a lab.
You don't have glasses, right? You know, I'm just not wearing them today. I haven't worn them in months. I'm blind and shit. But I'm smart too, bro.
No, I'm not saying that. But
that is what you're saying,
judging,
right?
I'm not judging whether you're smart.
I'm not judging.
You're saying engineers aren't.
I'm just saying stick with engineering. That's all.
Stick with engineering.
Elon Musk. Hey. Elon Musk.
There you go.
What about him?
He was an engineer.
Oh, that's amazing.
Stick with engineer, don't see.
He says engineers think the best way because like they solve problems.
Oh, that I don't.
Scientists just research.
I don't fully agree.
Scientists just research.
I don't fully agree with that.
But y'all really just be chilling in the lab all day and research.
Actually, a lot of people think that's what we do.
That's
why I try to change it.
Collaborating.
I've actually managed to talk a few of my students out doing PhD, not doing PhD, because I actually don't think it suit them.
What else would
they
have suited them?
They end up being dentists and doctors right now.
which is much better than which what is the fuck much better. Doing.
Why do you
better
want to you? Be an engineer?
Yeah, I want to be an
engineer. No, like for me, I think
you don't think
like,
I could be a doctor
because
huh?
science is always. I think way, way back, and you probably can back me up. Back me
way, way back.
No, this guy just throwing out shade.
No, no, you, yeah, yo, you came in shy. I thought you were shy and shit. Now I lean back. You know,
way, way back, no, like 60, 70
guys,
years ago.
You guys Kieran. Are my friends. Yeah. So I, no, like science has always been like a privilege. Like, it's more like a hobby for these, like, the rich. Way back.
Is that how it started?
Because it's not, like, it's not necessarily for, like, yeah, survival. It's extra.
Yeah, it's not. Yeah.
They don't have to worry about surviving.
And you don't make a lot of money out of it.
Yeah,
so.
You don't make much money.
It's there you go. Yeah, you are correct. Yeah. So for me, I feel like, but you need to earn it. You need to be somewhat elite. But nowadays, people do PhD for the wrong reason. People do it because they want to stay in Australia. I guess that's probably a good true. Reason.
Didn't Jared say that last week? People in America, they do that.
Yeah,
to stay.
That's why he did it, to stay a couple of years.
It's probably a good reason. But again, like PhD is hard. Like you really, to me, it's like you really need to like science. Like
be passionate.
I don't understand why you'd want a career in academia. Yo, I don't get it. I don't get it. Unless you love teaching, I don't understand it.
You need to like it. You need to be passionate to be able to do it well and do it long. That's why I keep on saying. And I see a lot of these young students coming in, not knowing, and say, oh, yeah, I might as well do a PhD. I say, no, why?
Like, what are you passionate about? Like,
when I'm passionate, I when I'm passionate about something, I do it well and long as well.
There you go.
Yeah, when I'm passionate about it.
Which is not very often. Often it's late and short.
You need to dig deep.
But it's satisfying.
Look, as long as you're happy with the outcome.
I'm happy.
That's it.
I'm happy. I'm good.
There's definitely no commitment to a longer term investment. I get it.
Yo, don't perpetuate this game. People are listening.
We haven't stopped yet. People are still recording.
Still recording, bro. You forgot. Alright, so you got to be passionate to do what you do.
You really need to be passionate.
And invest. Like,
yeah, invest your time.
I had a conversation this morning with my brother before he headed out back to Melbourne. He's asking me about, like, the podcast.
Yeah.
You know, and I was just telling him, like, I don't even know why. I just find myself here again every week because I enjoy doing it. That's I don't know why I.
Great.
I'm like, for some reason, I just want to do it. And I was like, all right, cool. I'll just keep following that. I don't know. Yeah. Might not want to next week, but this week I want to. You know?
I like turning up. Like, you turn up and then just see what it's about. And then every time I turn up, even if I'm like, don't feel like it, yeah. I'm like, yeah, this is cool.
Always after, it's like, man, I'm glad I turned up.
Yeah.
Yeah, I do that.
And then when the edits come out, it's cool.
You know what I mean? I want to turn up, but I'm scared because, some of your episodes is deep. I was like,
This one's been deep. This one's just been
you shitting on everyone. Yeah. He's shitting on
this old guy over here. Yeah, and this guy's gonna be an engineer, like a bum. engineer.
Remember, like some of your previous few episodes, I was like, oh, I've not experienced any of that. I hope a Tim does not ask me any of those questions. But I have nothing.
What
to
was
give.
The question that I asked? That was like,
no, I think even the last couple where you were talking about, you work in. Jail system?
Yeah, in
the
prison system.
He used to, no, he didn't just work in the jails. He used to go off-site with the guards and, like, they'll box in their own little, they had, like a boxing cell, right, where you and the guards would go jujitsu and, like, you know, sharpen their,
skills.
The person that you invited that day, he was talking about, like, drugs and,
deep.
Yeah. I was like, whoa.
And that's deep. That's deep.
I enjoy it.
Paul Hahn's on his study, hang out with research assistants, run a lab, and run a league. Like it's kind of pretty.
That's deep as well.
That's his whole life.
But that's deep as well.
It's actually occupying all my life.
Because
because you're immersed in it, you're passionate,
you're committed,
and you do it well.
And I want to help people. I think I just want to give.
You want to give it well and long.
And consistently. And because of that, it's been successful.
And passionately, with a lot of passion. It's awesome, man.
I feel like you guys giving me a lot of compliment, but really.
No, they're compliment.
I'm not that great. Well, you have been in a relationship for 18 years, Han. I think that
you've been, you know, doing your
that's
job.
That's faithful. That's different from
being great.
Being great.
I disagree.
Oh, thank you.
Wait, can we explore that real quick? What does that mean?
Oh,
how
that was
long is the show?
No, I'm trying to end it, but you keep bringing up good shit.
That was
I'm
deep.
I'm trying to end it.
Being faithful is different.
Like, you bring up these great topics.
We'll save it
Can we speak on that next time?
Yeah.
Being faithful and being great are different. Oh, we got to explore that. I like that.
After the championship.
After championship.
I'm joking.
Wow.
I'm bleeping that one out.
Yeah, I've heard.
Han, thank you, man.
Thanks for
trying your best to accept some of these compliments. And because we do think
take
you're
some
great.
Of the spotlight.
And yeah, take some of the spotlight.
Which you've created.
I like
you created,
the spotlight,
yeah.
And thank you.
Thanks for, like, real talk, giving us an opportunity to, like, do shit we like. Like, fantastic. Just come play basketball where we're welcomed. Like,
and appreciated.
And appreciated.
And it's really cool to be appreciated.
That's the best thing about it, man. And the fact that you've provided that, and I've allowed him to provide that as well. I've allowed me to provide that as well, offer it. Man, we're grateful, bro.
Thank you.
And let's amplify this and...
Yeah, let's make it bigger and better.
Well, just keep showing up, you know what I mean?
Yeah, so I think the last message, if you want to come somewhere where you are appreciated, your skills are appreciated, your passion's appreciated, then, you know, come join us at BSBL because, you know, it's full of ballers who just appreciate the game and... Yep. You'll be celebrated because you're good at basketball. That's about it.
Yep. That's it.
Okay, who you bring to Olympians? We're winning. Thank you. God bless. BSBL, search this podcast, like, subscribe, follow, all that good stuff. God bless.
Thank you.
What? Oh, now let me... I'm going to leave you guys with a song, just in case.
The bag, wow. It's not the old one. Run up on this Rory, I'm clicking until it's over. Still a put a snow on a mission to Minnesota. Come on, you know the drill. Hop in and hand it over. I'm driving in the whip so fast I can't control it. I'm fish telling, leaving Javier's. I should have chauffeured. Chopping it up with Brian, bought real estate by the ocean. A sea moss juice, my bitch brought me one from Oakland. Today I drove the Porsche with the automatic front lift. I spent $1,000 on candles. I'm at Saks Fifth, tucked in the gas tank. Played the night shift, get on the nigga. Head like Kofi for disrespecting it. I'm thinking billions, cop another building. New whoop Cecilia, thinking bigger. You thought I was cooler, and I was taking risks. Palisades, chilling in the shade. Might take the bend, betting on myself. And every time, nigga, it's a hit.
We off in the Palisades.
Betting on myself, you know, every time, nigga.
I'm talking armed guards, gated communities, man. Royal family type shit.
Shine down. Hey, hey.
Look, if you not getting richer every year, then you just backwards hustling. You moving off emotion. I'm strategizing, discussing it. See, I've been on my supplements.
fish oils, chlorophyll, mold ties. My hair growing out and hoes loving it. Some people can't piece life together. It's really puzzling. Talking about trust me, I got you, but I'm not trusting it. Commercial real estate by the Fox. Yeah, they constructing it. Business flowing like the symphony orchestra. I'm conducting it. I crack my knuckles and neck, now I'm back to new. I had to comp a bitch, we not compatible. Team on the line, yeah, the lovers all lateral. You cannot practice for shit that's not practical. Fuck with the tactics, this shit could get tactical. Fuck with the rations, this shit get irrational. I cannot talk to you just like them hoes when they mad at you. I overwork and do shit I don't have to do. Stumble and stagger through, dodge all the bullets and dodge all the daggers. Who working these bitches and blessing them so long, I might as well take a sabbatical. I tell the truth like a polygraph in the wolf, but like these rappers doing, they pleading in front of the judge cause they feel like they having to. Judicial system is not a system, it's a trap for you, nigga. It's our season, yeah, Larry June. Shine when you dropping very soon. I get to transforming under every moon. When they bury me, they gotta bury tombs. I'm just one kid in, I can't be letting my seed all off in every womb. When you see me out, just know I'm the richest, rawest, rarest nigga off in every room. Yeah. Al, what up?
Betting on myself and every time, nigga, it's a hit.
Betting on myself every time, nigga, it's a hit.
This might be the motherfucking greatest escape.
It was during one of those summer rains.